should make for an interesting discussion in the Oval Office Monday. More new fallout tonight in the Fast and Furious investigation. The House Oversight Committee tonight demanding more answers from Attorney General Eric Holder. The latest scandal developments surrounding the murder of Immigration and Customs Enforcement agent Jaime Zapata. Zapata was murdered by Mexican drug cartel members in February of last year with a weapon connected to Fast and Furious. Now, documents show in October of 2010, Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms was investigating the straw purchaser for obliterating serial numbers on weapons before trafficking them to Mexico. The ATF chose to make no arrest. Meanwhile, the Attorney General reasserting claims he's trying to cooperate, telling Congress he appointed an inspector general. But those unraveling the facts have received only 6,000 pages of a requested 80,000-page inspector general's report. We're joined now by Congressman Trey Gowdy of South Carolina, a member of the House Oversight Committee and Judiciary, investigating Fast and Furious. Good to have you with us. And at what point does the committee decide this is a joke, it's time to press forward with contempt?
Well, I think the committee's already decided it's a joke. The question is, at what point do we resort to our legal process, which is contempt of Congress? You know Chairman Issa, you know Lamar Smith. They're patient men, but even their patience has some limits. My conversations with Chairman Issa suggest that we are moving forward. Of course, you got to keep in mind, we have to get the House to approve the contempt of Congress motion. Right. And then the Department of Justice, ironically enough, would have to enforce that. One would hope the president would step in at some point and say, hey, why don't you go ahead and give them the documents, since whistleblowers have already given them to them and they already know what they say. Why don't you go ahead and give them to them? We're getting closer. I think Chairman Issa is trying to show restraint, because contempt of Congress is a pretty serious allegation to make.
Well, it's pretty serious when the Attorney General of the United States and his department and an agency, the Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms Bureau, are obviously responsible for the deaths of 200 citizens of Mexico and two U.S. law enforcement officers. That's pretty serious, too.
Agreed. It's 200 up until now. There are thousands of weapons that are unaccounted for, and we'll be living with the consequences of this for the next 5 to 10 years. I full well agree with you. It is vitally important. You've seen Chairman Issa in committees. You've seen Lamar Smith in committees. They're engaged. They're on top of it. I'm not a committee chairman and probably won't live long enough to be one.
I like watching a congressman be modest, Congressman Gowdy.
I think what is happening is given the Attorney General's proclivities towards claiming politics and race baiting whenever he's criticized, I think Chairman Issa is trying to give him every opportunity to do this without having to go to the House and essentially having censured.
Well, you had to feel pretty good as a member of Judiciary and Oversight to hear the Attorney General say to the Appropriations Committee he was being treated differently there than what he's used to in other committees. You guys have set a very high standard.
I had a wonderful time making fun of my friends on the Appropriations Committee. I guess the guys that spend money aren't prosecutors and law enforcement officers. Kevin Yoder from Kansas said he asked him questions about Fast and Furious, but I was not pleased to hear that the Attorney General thoroughly enjoyed his visit. We'll try to correct that next time he comes before Oversight or Judiciary.
Congressman, great to have you with us.
Thank you, Lou.
Up next, what does Apple have waiting for consumers now?